Hello and welcome to Poseidwn Tech. In today's video, we have some Zigbee products, some sensors and a relay from SONOFF, as well as an Aqara leak sensor. But let's start from the most important product, this USB Zigbee 3 dongle. Let's unbox it. As you can see, it's just the USB hub and an antenna. Very small and robust. Let's unbox this motion sensor from SONOFF. This is the actual sensor and some paper, small as well. And this is a temperature and humidity sensor, also from SONOFF. Nothing special in the box, the actual sensor, some paper and some 3M tape. And this is a relay. The same paper. And the actual relay. That's it. Here are the connectors, line in, line out, the neutral and the switch. And also we have a leakage sensor. This is not from SONOFF, this is from Aqara. We will test this as well, and as you can see, this is not dependent on the brand. You can connect any Zigbee device to this Zigbee hub from any brand. For our testing, we'll use Home Assistant. First, we need to connect our Zigbee hub to the Home Assistant, which in our case is running on a Raspberry Pi. This is one of the easiest installations you can ever have. This is our Raspberry Pi with the Home Assistant installed, and as you can see, we are using a Poe hat. So the only thing we have to do is to connect this Zigbee hub to a USB port, and that's it. Now let's power up this Raspberry Pi via Poe switch, and that's it. That's all we need. As you can see, the power consumption for the whole Raspberry is from 1.8 watt to 3.6 watts, so nothing special, as we are expecting. The power consumption from the USB Zigbee hub is around 100 milliwatt. Now it's time to open Home Assistant and integrate our Zigbee devices. First, we need to go to Settings, Integrations, and as you can see, our Zigbee USB hub appears already here. We just need to press Configure, press Submit, select the area that our Zigbee hub is installed, and press Finish. That's it. Our Zigbee hub is ready. If we press here the devices, you can see that we have only two entities. No devices yet connected. In order to connect some devices, press here Add Devices, and it starts searching for Zigbee devices. Now we need to put our device in pairing mode. Let's start by putting our temperature and humidity sensor to pairing mode. In order to do so, we need first of all to remove the back cover. Remove this plastic under the battery. Now our sensor is powered on. And press the button in the bottom for 5 seconds. Until we have this blue LED flashing. Okay, it is ready. Now it's in pairing mode. It is able to be discovered from Home Assistant. Okay, the first device already appeared and is configuring. After some seconds, it is ready. As you can see here in the temperature and humidity sensor, we have several options. We can read humidity, power consumption, and temperature. That's it. Our first device is ready. Let's repeat the process. Now let's put our motion sensor in pairing mode. In order to do so, same procedure, remove the back cover. Okay, for this we'll need a small screwdriver. Remove this plastic under the battery. And in order to put it in pairing mode, we need this small pin and keep pressing the button for 5 seconds until the LED is flashing. Okay, that's it. Okay, the device appears again here. Our motion sensor appears here. It's configuring. And it's ready. Let's proceed with the next device. Now it's time to continue with the smart relay. First, we need to power it up. In order to do so, we need to connect it to the power, and we'll use a cable for that. Let's connect the line and the neutral, and let's power it up. As you can see, this is already in pairing mode. In case it is not, you just need to press this button for 5 seconds. And that's it. Now it is appearing in the Home Assistant. Okay, our relay is ready. Let's select an area. We have now 3 devices. Let's repeat the process again. Next, we need to put in pairing mode this leakage sensor from Aqara. Unscrew the cover in the bottom. This reveals the battery. Okay, and just press here in the middle for 5 seconds until you see the LED flashing. Okay, that's it. Now it's in pairing mode and should appear in Home Assistant. Our leakage sensor appear. And after some seconds it's ready. We have the option to select an area. And that's it. Now our 4 devices appear here, as well as the USB Zigbee hub. This was a really easy procedure. Now it's time to add the entities to the view. First with the sensor. Okay. Let's select the office, select the card. This seems okay. Perfect. Let's go to second device. We have here the option to appear in the view the sensor. Ready. Also we have the power here. Let's go to the control. Add this also to office view. And finally the leakage sensor. Let's add this as well. Perfect. As you can see, now we have all our devices, the Zigbee devices, connected to the hub, already configured in the Home Assistant and ready to be used. And also here appear on a specific view. That was a really easy procedure. In order to test our leakage sensor, we just need to shortcut the 2 connectors in the bottom. Let's try this using a piece of cable. Okay, as you can see, it switches from dry to wet, so it works perfect as well. That's it. In the video description, you can find links for all the products that appear here in our short demo. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, please press like and consider subscribing to our channel. See you on the next video.